back with us to watch this third group. And in the third group, we have Galina Maniachenko from the Ukraine, Sabina Wojtyla from Poland, two Poles in this group, Anna Lundström from Sweden, Yoshi Onda from Japan, Vanessa Guzmaroli from France, Anna Recknio from Poland, and finally Alisa Tley from Finland. Plenty of talent, but mostly in this third group, you're looking at girls who would have been a little disappointed, didn't do too well in their qualification. There's Yoshi Onda, who's third to go, qualified in eighth place in Group B. And she's fourth to go. 17 years old. Coached by Midori Ito's coach, Machiko Yamada. Ito, of course, a former world champion.
And she'll be looking to do better than... He's here, opening out on the flip. Looks very, very nervous indeed. Pierre Trant, Vanessa Guzmaroli. She had a nightmare in her qualification. Didn't skate well at all, and she's been so good all week.
Bronze medalist, of course, in the World Championships in 1997. Did very well in Vienna. Most people thought she was desperately unlucky not to get a medal. She was fourth.
Yeah, she skated fantastically in the Europeans, and she'll be looking for that sort of performance this afternoon in this short program to get her up the rankings. A lot of work for her to do, but she's still been skating well. Another one who skated completely against her form was Anna Recknio. She's been awesome on the practice sessions, just unbelievably consistent, and on the day couldn't do anything right. People starting to come back now. Not an awful lot of people in here this afternoon, is it?
No, I'd say around 3,500, packed out for the last two nights, and of course for the dance tonight. It's going to be a full house once again, and a real competition. Hope you can join us tonight. Remember the French under threat, Marina Anasina and Gwenol Pesera from the Italians. Barbara Fusopoli and Maurizio Magalio, who won the original dance. Confirmation of the order. We could see two or three very, very good skates here, particularly in the latter stages of the group.
It's a large group. Not very often you see seven skaters in a warm-up group. There's Vanessa Guzmaroli, looking for triple looks. She looks a little tight, looks a little anxious out there.
Alisa Drey, who's last to go from Finland.
She's going to have a long wait, you know, in this warm-up.
I can't remember the last time we had seven in a group.
No, they can have up to eight, but it does make it a little unfair for the skaters towards the end of the group, the last skater.
Yes. So long since your warm-up.
Yeah, that's right.
Alisa, who qualified in seventh place from her group. Here you've got girls who qualified from seventh through to ninth. She's a very neat little skater, is Alisa. Going to be wanting to move. 14th last year. Looking for a top 10 place this year if she can. 22 years old. Originally born in Moscow, but now living in Orihimaki. Final stages of the warm-up. And the coaches, you can see, looking very concerned. It's a difficult time for coaches as well as competitors.
It's important that you come off the practice session with a good feeling. You want your last jump to be probably one of your best. Important not to overdo it on the 6-minute warm-up.
Yep, that's how to do it. Now we're ready to go. First on the ice will be a young lady from the Ukraine. Delightful skater, just one big mistake in her qualifying, which means that she's down in ninth place going into the short. 19 years old from Kiev in her first World Championships. Michel Legrand's love story, the music, and the skater Galina Maniachenko. Combination and good triple Lutz double toe.
There's a long preparation into that, but a good clean combination.
Solo jump is the triple flip, and that's 0.4 off straight away. I love her skating. Travel on the spin, mistake on the triple flip. I think she's got a wonderful skating style. Love her to do well, Galina Maniachenko.
Yeah, she's very, very natural out there, and she does have a lovely style and a good jumping technique as well. Took a long, long time winding up the jump. Sometimes that gives the opportunity for negative thoughts to creep in. I had deductions there of 0.5, 0.4 for the fall on the jump, the solo jump, and a 0.1 deduction for not getting a good position in the flying spin in the air. There's that combination. All started very, very well indeed. That's the position in the flying camel, but you're required to get a good flying position, and she didn't get a lot of elevation on the flying part of the spin. There, down on the flip, she'd done all the hard work there. See, just a little bit late with the opening. Double axel, no problem with that. A beautiful landing position. Really gets down in the knee, which creates a very soft flow to the end of the jump. Layback spin, good. A lot to admire. A wonderful straight line step sequence as well. So the base mark will be very good for the program before the deductions.
Lovely expression. She really does have a genuine feel for the music. Galina Kukar. who trains her, also trains Dmitry Dmitrenko. The second mark will be a lot better than the first, you can be sure of that. 4-3, up to 4.8. She's going to slot in second place. She'll take the lead at second place on the short behind Chris's friend.
Marks for presentation.
And the Romanian judge has her first, otherwise second right across the board. That's the situation. But overall, she leads. Pot second, Fontana from Italy is third. But plenty more to go.
Thank you.
Sur la glace, représentant la Pologne.
On the ice. So now we go to the girl who qualified in ninth place from her group, Group B. Second World Championship. She was 22nd last year in Helsinki. This is Sabina Wojtyla from Poland with Gypsy Romance. Start, triple Lutz, double Tolu.
Well, that was a wonderful Lutz.
May have been a change of plan there, because in the notes that we have down, she was due to do triple toe, and then a triple Lutz as the solo jump. Maybe this new combination is working. Let's see what she does here. It's going to be the loop. And it works as well. She gets the axle. This is heavenly stuff from Wojtyla. Diana Park is going to lose her lead on the night, but no tears yet from Chris Howarth alongside me. That was great though, wasn't it?
It was very, very good. I thoroughly enjoyed it. What a wonderful style she has, and the jumping technique working brilliantly today.
Now it's interesting, isn't it, this change of routine. The notes that we get are from Marit Marismussen, who's an absolute expert on the jumps. She goes down and watches all the practices, just as many as Chris, if not even more. And this is what she's been doing in practice, but there's been a change of mind in the routine, and it's worked.
Yeah, it's important. We were talking about it earlier. It's important to make sure that you go out there and whatever you do, you feel comfortable with and you feel consistent with. And we've seen from watching the practices, from watching the programs last night, skaters who are usually really, really consistent on a particular jump may suddenly lose the timing, lose the rhythm, lose the feel, and not feel confident with it. And then you've got to look at your program and change it around. And it worked perfectly for her. It's a dangerous thing to do this late in a championship, but didn't it work well? Look at that loop. Well, she's got a textbook position in the air. Look, ankles nice and tight, dead straight.
Well, she's going to put herself in contention for a top 10 finish, which will be terrific for her. 22nd last year in Helsinki. She had a disaster in the Europeans. Remember, she didn't qualify there, 26th place in the end, after being 10th last year. This is her true form, what we've seen this afternoon.
Yeah, I had one small deduction in there, 0.2, because the circular step sequence wasn't completed. She didn't complete the circle. But apart from that, I couldn't see any other deductions.
Not that you were looking for deductions for your Miss Poth, but...
No.
No.
I wouldn't do that.
No. But she's going to be very, very pleased indeed. When she sees the marks that are coming up right now. These four, the elements, yeah, 4.6 up to 5.3.
5-0, 5-0, 5-0.
And they'll be even stronger for presentation, and she is going to take the lead.
Marks for presentation.
Yeah, 6-3. Six for her, three for the Hungarian. But Wojtyla moves into the lead in the short. Diana Poth second, Galina Maniachenko is third.
5-0, thank you.
Like it's Takeshi Honda, who did so well last night. He had a terrific free program, and one of the best. But let's focus on the ladies here. And this young lady qualified in eighth place. Her second world, didn't qualify before in her first worlds, which was in Minneapolis a couple of years ago. Didn't even make worlds last year. But here she is with a real chance of doing something. 19 years old from Karlskrona in Sweden. Anna Lundström with Rodgers and Hammerstein's If I Loved You. The free leg was very close to the ice, but it may have stayed off.
I think there was a double-footed landing on that. Difficult to see, and judges will be using their instant replay system on that.
Another combination. Triple toe, double toe. She has been doing triple-triple. Again, the free leg dangerously closed, but I think that time stayed off.
No, I'm pretty sure it's a double-footed landing again.
Really? What a cutthroat mood you're in this afternoon. Crowd loved it, and most of them won't have spotted what eagle-eyed Howarth spotted, which are those two double-footed landings. Let's find out now whether he's right or whether that Hungarian bias was raising its ugly head once more.
Oh, that was below the belt. Well, she's a lovely skater. Another skater with a fantastic feel to the music. I love the start with a spiral sequence. And that was superb. Very graceful on the ice. There's a part of the spiral sequence that all of the skaters have to perform. Do it in a serpentine pattern or in a circular pattern. Now here's the double axel. Let's see whether that left foot did touch down. There it is. So a deduction there, 0.2. There was no problems with this at all. You see the leg come out nice and early. Double toe on the end. A good quality combination.
Not sure we're going to see the loop. But you're pretty sure that it was a two-footed landing there as well.
Yeah, it's difficult to tell from the commentary position up here. We're quite a long way up, but I'm sure the foot touched, and there it is.
Yeah, you're right. Hate to say it, but you're right again.
Good position in that flying spin. Late into the back sit.
It's interesting, when you see the landings of the jumps there, you know that that's a habit that she's got into, of giving support with that free leg.
Certainly when she's under pressure, I think the free leg tends to come down. And it's a security thing, you know, when you're not quite sure, your confidence is a bit rocked, you don't feel quite right out there, it's an easy thing to do. Bit of security, the foot there just to make sure that you don't fall.
But as Chris mentioned, the judges now have this instant replay. They might not have noticed it before, but now they will. And that's why the marks are as they are there. Plenty of deductions. The presentation was good. It was a good feel. 4-1 up to 4.9. She's going to slot in fourth place.
1-4-5-4-5. Thank you.
Even though the second marks will be good. Look at that 5-2 from the Ukrainian judge. But most of the placing is fourth. And that's where she is, both in the short and overall so far. Wojtyla still leads. Maniachenko second. Diana Poth is third. Second on the night. Or the afternoon, rather. Good competition so far.
Sur la glace, représentant le.
So, still four to go in this group. And here's the young lady who qualified in eighth in her group, in group B. Had a really good free skate in the Four Continents Championship. Moved up from 10th to 5th, but she messed up in the short. Let's hope she doesn't do that here. 17 years old from Aichi is Yoshi Onda. Now her Lutz. Yes, gets that as well. good indeed. Double axel. Yeah, nailed it. That language is international. Big, big smiles all round, and why not? She's got a good style, hasn't she? And she really did put in the technical stuff here this afternoon.
Yeah, I love that. Not as graceful as some of the other skaters, but boy, has she got attack. So much elevation on those jumps, so much energy. A little powerhouse. Particularly like the double axel is one of the easier elements, but she gets so much elevation.
Well, Japan have missed out on success in the ladies competition, of course, since Midori Ito, who was such a phenomenal skater in the 80s, but nothing in the last, what, 15 years? Who knows? This is her first world. She's only 17 years of age. She might be just what they need.
It's interesting, she's got a very similar technique to Midori on the axel, and I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see a triple axel from her in the not-too-distant future.
Really? There's been no one, has there, in competition, who's been producing triple axel in the last decade.
Yeah, Tony Harding could do it, but apart from that, didn't.
Yeah, no.
There's one thing doing it, there's another thing doing it in competition. Look at that. Fantastic energy on the takeoff.
As you said, she looked as if she was within herself.
Yeah, there's room for another turn there. Won't be long.
All she needs is the right blades, Chris.
Hey.
Chris,
and they won't be that long either.
Right, Chris is working and developing a new blade which will be suited to each specific skater. Give them just a little bit more purchase on the takeoff.
That's right. Some of the slow motion shots we've seen, the way the toe slides away from you on the takeoff of the toe loop and the flip. And I've come up with a design that'll give you more purchase if you don't spot correctly. So we'll see how that develops.
4-9, 5-3, 5-1. 4-9
up to 5-3 for the elements. 5-1, 5-1. It's just a little unlucky not to be a little bit more.
Mark's representation.
Yeah, she's going to slot in second on the night. Voitula leads her, which I suppose is about right. She's in second place on the night, on the afternoon, and second place overall. Diana Poch is still third. No doubting where this young lady comes from. From Annecy in France, the bronze medalist in 97, but with some work to do here. There's Didier Gayagi, the head of the French Federation. A delightful skater on her day. Will it be thus for Vanessa Guzmaroli? Double toe, has been doing triple toe, but wanted to play safe and probably dead right. Second jump, which will be the triple flip. he's got that too. So far by some way, a new leader. She's got a whole lot of work to do because she was so poor at a qualification, but she's on her way. I think she's left herself too much to do to get a medal, but you never know. She can produce like that tomorrow afternoon, it just may be hers, as long as there are mistakes from those around her. But the important thing is that she's got some momentum going now.
Yeah, she's certainly in the frame. That was top class from Vanessa Gusmeroli. Good to see. When she's on form, she's a real force to be reckoned with. A wonderful program. I love the contrast with the change of music. Really got going at the end there with that circular step sequence. Just the start she was looking for. A good triple Lutz. Now, if she'd got a bit more of a kick out of the landing of that Lutz, she may well have been able to do the triple toe in the end. She opted for safety there, and it was the right decision. No doubt about that. There's a triple flip. That was a corker. Some good spins. Just thought that the final spin that she did, the flying camel, you need to do 8 rotations in the flying in the camel position, and I had her short. So there could be a 0.1 deduction on the final spin.
And of course, later on, and we're talking in terms of her and the last group, there'll be triple-triple combinations. So greater tariff there. No deduction, but greater tariff. But she's going to go into the lead, and lead by some way. These will be the best marks you've seen. 5-2 up to 5.6. Stanislav Leonovic, who trains her.
5-2, 5-5, 5-5. Thank you.
So it's going to be a very interesting next couple of hours for Vanessa to see how many go above her, but she's done what she went out to do this afternoon, and the French here are thrilled with her performance. Could be a big day for France, of course, with Anasina and Pezzera going for gold in the ice dance tonight. A big thank you for her supporters from Vanessa Gusmeroli, and here's another who's got just the same ability but has such a fragile temperament. Important moments now. As her coach Miroslava Borchevska sends her out. This is Anna Rechnio. So much ability. 5th in the world in Minneapolis, 6th last year. And now she's ready. Harlem Nocturne is her music. Anna Rechnio qualified in 9th place. Thank you. combination. Ah! It's such a familiar sight, I'm afraid. But just as depressing. She's going to salvage something. She has to nail this. This is the triple flip. Confidence is just shot to pieces. Just look at this. Can she skate or what? Good, but not enough, I'm afraid. I don't really know what to say, Chris. It's so familiar, and it just bears repetition, doesn't it? She has got such talent, and yet there's little achievement this year. Last year, so much promise. Didn't go to Europeans, but sixth in the worlds. But this year, the confidence has gone completely.
It is absolutely amazing that you watch her on the practice sessions, and she's a medal contender. She skates so fast, she's so strong, and rarely puts her foot wrong. Yet under pressure, she rarely puts her foot right. It is so sad. Well, I don't know if she does any work with a sports psychologist or anything like that, but if she doesn't, she needs to. Because she's got the talent. It's all there. She is so fast across the ice. Honestly, she skates faster than the guys do. And it's just great watching her.
Step sequence is wonderful.
It was. So much of the program was good. The spiral sequence was good. The spins were excellent. Just such a pity. Well, that's the sort of quality of jumps that she can do. I feel for her, I really do, because she knows that she's talented. She knows she's capable of competing with the very, very best.
Quality in everything she does, but two awful jumps mean that she's going to drop, I'm afraid, like a stone. 4-0, 3.6 on the German judge, up to 4.2, but considering she's going in this group with all the mistakes that she made, they're not too harsh.
Thank you.
Presentation, look how much better they are there. Sixth down attempt, she slots in sixth place.
You can see their deductions of 0.8.
Yes. Good luck for next year to Anna Reknio. Now to the last of the seven skaters in this group. As Chris was saying, she's had to wait an awful long time to compete after a warm-up. Trains in Paris with Trant and Gaillager. seventh place in the qualification. Songs from the victorious city for Alisa Dre. Double toe.
Another scheduled to be triple triple.
Now for the loop. Yes. A little out of sync with the music at the end, but terrific spins, and the important thing is that she went clean.
Yes, no major deductions there. She doesn't get the elevation of some of the other skaters on the jumps, but as you rightly said, she did go clean. She would have been looking for that triple-triple combination at the beginning, but it's been, by my reckoning, about 36 minutes since she's been on the ice, and that is awfully difficult. There's a triple toe. You can see she's got a lot of speed across the ice, a bit too much over the toe on the landing of the first jump, and just lost the momentum for the second one. Good triple loop, lovely clean landing. She rotates so quickly in the air.
Well, she moved up from 25th in Minneapolis in 98 to 14th last year, and she's put herself in contention for a top 10 place, so she's really on the move. A later developer than some. She's 22 years old now. Twice been in the, three times been in the top 10 in Europeans, but never really done it at Worlds. This could be it. Born in Russia, moved to Finland with her mother several years ago. Looks very comfortable out there.
Well, still all the big guns to go. I think I'll have her down in fifth place at the moment.
Fifth place in front of Diana.
No, behind. Fifth place on the day.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Yeah. I got that wrong, didn't I?
You did.
Yeah.
Pay attention.
I think I have a fourth, just to annoy you.
Well, there's a surprise. But very well done. She skated well.
I think this might be the first time you're wrong in the last couple of days.
Not a chance.
Watch it. Watch with interest.
Marks 4.
Alisa Dry. Note pour les éléments exigés.
Marks for required elements.
So first for the elements. She can't wait. She's pretty optimistic. 4.6 up to 4.9.
4.5, 4.9, 4.7, 4.6.
Howell's in my face because he's right again.
4.7.
Both is fourth and Elisa Dre is fifth.
4.9, 4.8. Thank you.
Note pour la présentation.
Marks for presentation.
And for presentation. Yeah, well, they haven't really gone for that. Very close. As you see, four sixth places, three fifths, but a fourth and a second from the Romanian judge, which is why she does move into fifth on the afternoon.
On the ice, representing Ukraine,
Elena Lyachenko.
So Chris is very happy indeed. Those are the current standings then, including the short program. Guzmaroli leads by a country mile from Sabina Wojtyla. Yoshi on the third. Elisa Dre is fifth on the afternoon, but fourth overall in front of Diana Pov.
Victoria Volchkova.